Welcome back. In this tutorial video, I'm going to go over a custom contract template. If you go to the Home tab of the client, you'll see all the smart contract templates. We will click on the custom contract. This gives you the option of a normal custom contract or a Python smart contract. This feature will be released at a later date. So for now, the only custom contract that works is the normal contract template. All right, once you click on that, you have a few introductory options to choose from first. First being is which marketplace you wish to place this contract in. The default marketplace everyone is subscribed to is BitBay. If you go to the markets tab here, you could create any kind of marketplace you want, any name you want. And then after you've joined that, with a little work from your computer doing a little POW proof of work to fight against spam, it would show up in this drop-down menu. For example, I'm also a member of Bill's Bike Shop. So you could either choose the default BitBay marketplace, Bill's Bike Shop, or you could send this contract to a private email, someone else's Bit message address, or someone else's BitBay coin address. So lots of options to choose from, and gives you a lot of privacy in the process. For this example, we'll stick with the BitBay default marketplace. And this first option is self-explanatory. Do you want to automatically accept first valid offers? It's up to you. If you want to know who your customer is and you're worried about their reputation system first, you'd uncheck this. If you're not worried about their reputation system, which in all honesty, if you have a double deposit system, if they don't honor it, they're going to lose money. So it's up to you. This next option is the allow counter offers or bids, which let's say you're wanting to sell your item. You give the counterparty the option to say, well, I'll buy it, but I want to buy it for this and this and this amount. This just gives you and the counterparty that option to negotiate that way as a first step before really even entering into escrow. Because once that counter offer comes back to you, you can accept it or deny it and go from there. All right, we'll accept that for now. The next option, supply additional contact information, different ways for payments. If you want to explain shipping costs, this just gives you the ability to include that in the contract. So buyers or your counterparty, so it doesn't have to be just buyers, but sellers. Let's say you're wanting to buy shoes. You could put a buy contract out for shoes and a seller could see it. But basically you have additional contact information you can place in the contract that would show up in the marketplace. That way people could see that extra information and say, well, I can't comply with that, and I'll just move on and find something else. That way it cuts out a little bit of a wasted effort trying to contact each other, making sure you're on the right page before you even get started. And this last one is allow chat and escrow. We highly recommend this, basically because if something happens along the way, this is a very secure, way more secure than email. It's bit message powered chat box, and it just gives you all sorts of options. You can do personal messages, you can send information on payments, all within the encrypted bit message technology. Okay, and we'll accept. And other contact information, this is just a safety precaution in case something happens. You could always leave your email address, phone number, IRC name, and tox name, contact, any other contact information you want to apply. And you can always save this profile for next time. It'll store it for you for next time. All right, and we can just create a description. Hello world, buy my spam bacon and ham. All right, in this field you have the option to attach an image. If the image is too large, it will automatically resize it. Remember I mentioned before in that introductory window that you get to choose which marketplace you want to place the item in. The default marketplace is BitBay, which I chose, and these marketplaces are basically just a, they call them a bit message chan, which is basically an address that a bit message address that broadcasts whatever people send to it. Even though this doesn't say bit message or BitBay, this is the BitBay bit message address that you're going to send to. Whereas if Bill's Bike Shop, which was I was also a member of, if I had clicked on that, this address would have been totally different, similar but different digits and numbers, or digits and letters. All right, here's the amount. We will go with $1,000, 1,000 coins. This option gives you whether you're a buyer or a seller. Let's say you wanted to sell spam and bacon and ham. You would put 1,000 for 1,000 BitBays. You would put I pay this amount for it. Whereas if you were buying, or if you were the seller, you would simply click on this window and the other party pays this amount. So you have a set fee here. Again, this in no way is a profit to the developer. This is just a standard Bitcoin protocol, anti-dust feature, whatever you want to call it, just that helps keep the blockchain secure because the miners receive this fee for securing the blockchain. All right, here we will make it a true double deposit escrow. So we will deposit 1,000 Bays. The counterparty, you can, again, this is a custom contract, so you could place whatever amount you wish for them. 1,000 coins, and you could, or you could change yours to 500. Time to complete, you have either days or hours. And this is very important. If the contract is not completed in this time frame, then the contract bombs and both you lose your coins stuck in deposit escrow. So it's very important you don't have you know, something stupid like a 1 hour contract. So we'll go 30, we'll go 60 days because I'm gonna try to sell something and the buyer potentially is in Guam. Okay, we are ready to create the contract, and here we have the BitMessage address, which is the BitBay default marketplace. It's just showing you the BitMessage address that associated with it. Purchase amount. This is what the other people will pay to get it. The fee. Again, that's just to support the blockchain. It doesn't go to any developer. BitBay is 100% nonprofit. My deposit, their deposit, and escrow, and the amount of hours, which was equates out to the 60 days. We did not do instant refund. That's for advanced contracts. And then who pays? You change address and the amount I'm going to pay, which is my deposit. Click OK. Enter your password. Enter your second password. And it's complete. Now, if we go to the pending offers tab, you will see the contract here. If you had an image, you could see it in here. Shows the amount. It has a price tracker on it. So 1,000 BitBays is currently 51 cents. It shows you that it's a custom deposit. What I've deposited, what they will deposit, and how much time is there. And here in this field, let's say you wanted to send the request again, you could just click on this. Yes. And to make sure everything's working right, you could always go to the send or receive BitBay tab and look in the outbox. And there's your order going through the BitBay BitMessage system, which it just completed. It's doing a little proof of work. And it just completed, so it didn't really. It's somewhat fast, and now you're just waiting for it to propagate into the marketplace. And there it is right here. So if someone else had the BitBay marketplace open, they could see all these and click on your item. And if they like what they see, they could accept, or they could counter offer, or they could just send a private message to them. And there you go. So, all right. Well, that completes a making your own custom contract from the custom contract template. Thanks for watching.